Okay, that's better, that's better. That put me grid. Right. We're gonna get the RAM. We're gonna get the new deck. I think I needed 5K for the eye upgrade. That's not too bad. We can re-get that. Question is, do I want more RAM? Buffer size. Oh, that doesn't actually require any, causes target to exit combat state. Yeah, I like that because. Oops, I accidentally set you off. Let's go back to how things were. Okay, so up there is the building I wanted to get into, though. Leave him a little bit more in the corner here. Okay, so they definitely know it's me when that happens. Hey, buddy, I'm just gonna come hang out with you here. Is that cool? Is that cool? Well,
damn
it. I wasn't going to save Scum, but I am stuck in the corner. So, kind of got it. Whoops. ICE stands for Intrusion Countermeasure Electronics. Oh, hey, nice. This should already be after I have upgraded my cyber deck, right? Yes, I've upgraded the cyber deck. There was literally nothing in there. Fantastic. Good times. It's kind of cool that they have the locked doors that don't go anywhere. Because with that, then it's like, hey, you know, we're admitting that there's nothing over there, but at least they make it interactable, you know? Kind of a cool little tidbit. Alrighty. So we need a different mission. Track cycle. Discover. Who knows what you might find. Spontaneous craving satisfaction machine. I think that's called a restaurant, Suki. Okay. That's a bad accident. Oh, Little China. Uh-oh. All right, dude.
I'm innocent.
I mean, dude, I feel like you're anything but innocent, but...
I'm gonna send you some malware, on purpose. A demon by bad. The runner you're gonna help out.
It's important.
You gotta hack a mega building subnet. Spike it with the files I send you. More deets attached.
Agent Saboteur. Oh. Bad got in touch with me. They like short nicknames and simple gigs, so I'll spare you the fixer spiel and get you to the point. You'll find Bad's malware attached to this message. You have to download it, just be careful, it's hella dangerous, and then upload it to the subnet in the H11 mega building. Piece of cake, right? Sorry to burst your bubble, but you'll have tigers on the prowl. Bad's plan is to attack some Arasoka subnet and use H11 as a smokescreen. Clever, right? Instead of leading to them, all traces of Bad's breach lead right back to the mega building. FYI, our Netrunner already hacked the mega building elevator, so getting into the server room won't be a problem. Resident. Oh, look! Server room. Okay, yeah, I could see a vending machine, Suki. But if I have a craving, I feel like it's not something... A vending machine is not going to have what I crave. Given the limited variety of things that they can handle. Hello. Nice. Oh yeah, ping is hella nice. Down here. Zoom-a-dump-a-dump. Nothing to see here. Your techs are all totally still here doing stuff. Contracts. Oh, nope. Oh. Oh, good, please. I think you could just stay there. Maybe not. That looks like a guy who may or may not be asleep. Join your buddies. Curious. This can be loud. It looks like it's kind of loud, but not like alarming everyone in the zone loud. Ah, I already turned off all the cameras, but we'll turn them off anyway. Sit tight, paces of virtue. Server room's useful, guarding it, let no one in. Feeling alone and kinky. Lunch another shipment of glitter. I think glitter is code for drugs. Some sort of drugs. Like one more guy back there. Not sure what is going on with him. Definitely actually goes up though. Check out what's up here. Oh. That's a blue chest. It's very juicy. That's some really good pants. Thought it was pants. Oh no, maybe I do have pants. Nope, my shorts are still better. Oh well. The law of fantasy armor remains infallible. Oh, darn. I think this guy is like inside a chair or something. He's either asleep or inside VR. The Undoing, the Fall of the First Net. Yep, we have that one already. Who is Dr. Paradox? Who is Doc Paradox? Who's hiding behind the distorted mask? Unsurprisingly, Doc Paradox won't say. After all, he's breaking the law. He has to protect his identity. If he revealed even the tiniest sliver about himself, Netwatch agents would be at his door in less than a minute. But think about it. Think, what kind of person could successfully hide from the world's most powerful corporations for years? Who could hack into encrypted TV channels? Who could disclose highly classified corporate secrets? The answer's obvious. Doc Paradox is one of them. He's a puppet controlled by the establishment. To what end? Maybe this is how the corporations funnel our anger and frustration in a safe and controlled manner. To a rebel who will never go so far as to issue a call to arms. Maybe he's being used to reveal facts that hurt the competition, or maybe just a branding opportunity. In a month or two, Avante could put out a new Doc Paradox line for us to wear our disapproval? Only time will tell, but for Christ's sakes, don't listen to a word out of his phony mouth. You know, they make a very valid point. He was worth a lot of street cred. nobody here. Just leaving. Oh, bonuses. Oh, I already got that one. Okay, I do have to kill them for the street cred. Well, sorry guys. Normally I'm a non-lethal player. But... yeah, you're both worth creds. Okay, they're all actually dead. Yep, fully dead.